Hello, my dear friend, class 9. Now, today I am going to discuss about the lesson 11, A Shipwrecked Sailor, written by Daniel Defoe. So, it's a normal rule before going to discuss about the prose, we have to know about the title and the writer, about the author. So, shipwrecked sailor. Here, the ship, which is actually, sunken, it was actually dissolved inside the sea. Jeta jole tolay dhuke gache, thongsho hoye gache, take amra bolchi shipwrecked. Sailor means nabi, the man, the pilot who actually proceed the or driving the or sails the ship in the sea. So it's a story about a sailor, or about a ship driver whose ship was broken. Ship was actually wrecked. Means ship was actually dissolved, sunk into the sea in a dismal island, in an unknown island. So in that manner, the title is quite appropriate here. So Daniel Defoe was an English writer and journalist. English writer. তিনি একজন লেখক ছিলেন, ইজ এ নর্মাল অথর অ্যান্ড এ জার্নালিস্ট, সাংবাদিকও ছিলেন. সো ইজ মোস্ট ফেমাস ফর ইজ নোভেল রবিনসন ক্রুসো. দ্যাট রবিনসন ক্রুসো অ্যাকচুয়ালি নোটিস আস দ্য জার্নি, আননোন জার্নি ইন ডিফারেন্ট প্লেসেস ইন দিস আর্থ. সো অল দ্য স্টোরি প্রোভাইডস ইউ some new information about the world. So lot of unknown story, untold story, what never been discovered by anyone, that was given a perfect description in the novel The Robinson Crusoe. This story also a part of that novel, the Robinson Crusoe. He was a prolific and versatile writer, acceptable and popular, and the writings is very easy and lucid language. Prolific and versatile, acceptable and popular among the common people in the world. Defoe is also known for pamphlets and journals on various topics. He also wrote some different social structure and unknown world through the pamphlets, prachar patra and kinds of leaflets and journals, periodicals, masik patrika, sanmasik patrika moddhe tini likhten in different topics. Journey to a moon, journey to an unknown island, journey to a the desert, journey to a fictional world. So lots of story you will get through his writing. The following text is adapted from a section of Daniel Defoe's famous novel Robinson Crusoe, and tells us how Crusoe, after being shipwrecked, after being broken the ship into the sea, what would happen? He was totally lost the sight, he was totally lost the distance and the direction of the sea, and ultimately he found himself on a dismal island. It was actually an unknown island, which was totally blank, no inhabitant were there, and he got nothing, any connection to the other land for getting the help with food, fire and rest. So he was totally alone there. So it's inspiring account of how makes the island habitable with his hard work. Ultimately a man, how used himself in different purposes and make the place usable, make the place more perfect for living. That was the main story here. Now story start on September 30, 1959. A miserable Robinson Crusoe, being shipwrecked during a violent storm, came on shore on this dismal island. So once upon a time on 13 September, date Tamaragwe, 3 September 1959, at a prachondo jhode, as a huge storm had broken the sea and it was transformed into different side, and ultimately he reached towards an unknown island. So that unknown island, I call it the island of despair. I was almost dead and the rest of my ship's company was drowned. I had neither food, house, nor clothes. Kichui chirona, nothing was there, nothing would be rest remained. He was almost dead, pray mitopray, morei giyechilo. Kiki chilo, he was drowned, ekdom puro dube giyechilo, he was totally sank into that sea. And what he had, neither food, house, nor clothes. Jama kapore chilo na, house chilo na, khabar to durer kotha. And I was feared I would be devoured. Barba Tajanathri, he was afraid whether he would be eaten, he would be killed by the wild creatures. And it rained all night. And the place actually came on, it was rained whole night. The weather was totally damp and wet. Which date Robinson Crusoe fish a violent storm? What happened after the violent storm? Why he was fearful in this unknown island? What normally happened in this island at night? The rain continued through the next day with a gust of wind. It was continued, the rain continued through the next day. It was not an up day. It starts from the night and it's continued for next day. And you know, with the gust of wind, it's a heavy wind, gust of wind. Only a wreck of my ship was to be seen at low water. Means only the nothing is remained. Sabi dhamsho hoyechilo, all was ruined. Only a wreck, a portion of the ship was remaining, and this was shown by the author on the low water. I swam to the wreck to rescue and secure for my survival some food and other provisions. The narrator was really wants to save anything, any what would actually remains there, whether there are some food, whether there are some things which is appropriate, which is providing food, fire and rest in this unknown island. I was able to collect some wood, cable, string, a knife, nails and can. And what are the things? What are the things the narrator actually collect from the wrecked ship? The knife, nails, wood, cables, etc. I also collected a hammock. It's a cloth, they have heavy cloths for preparing for campusing a tent. And some canvas with which I made a tent. Ar kichuta tripol type of jinis canvas to make the tent. I got some ink and paper. I also found some money, but they were useless to me in this barren island. He also got some money. But you know, money is nothing. Money is just an exchanging unit. So in this barren island, in this dismal island, in this unknown island, it was totally helpless, useless. Kono prayojan nahi hoy takatar, because it never transmitted you to food, fire and rest. I was some 100 leagues out of the ordinary course of the trade of mankind. I was convinced I had to spend the rest of my life alone in this wild and desolate island. Means the narrator was really, really hopeless. He maintained his mind. He actually tried to make him understand that he have to spend the later life here in this alone island, because he had no chance to connect with others. What notes will occur with Umbra? That was the shipwreck. I searched long for a place of a safe habitation. I searched long, means the narrator was searching here and there for a proper living place. I found a little plain on the side of a rising hill. On the rocky wall of the hill, there was a hollow place warning like the entrance to a cave. On the flat of the green, just before this hollow, I resolved to pitch my tent. So the narrator found here and there, and finally he got some little plan. Kichuta shomoy she pelo ei uchu pahadi elakay jeta tar mone hochhilo onekta guhar moto. Ebong on the rocky wall of the hill, there was a hollow place at a phapa jayga. Samne ekta birat boro stone diye entrance ta dhaka, and it was like a cave, guhar moto. On the flat green, just before the hollow, see phapa jayga tar samne ache ekta birat green field, I resolved to pitch my tent. I was totally busy to start my tent. Tambuta toiri jate kora jay. I cut the wood. I collected into stacks. I dropped them into the ground in a semicircle around my tent. The stacks stood 6 inches apart from each other. I put the cables I had rescued from the sea around the stacks in the manner of a fence. I used a short ladder to go over the fence. Once in, I withdrew the ladder after me, so that I was completely fortified against the world outside. Into this tent, I bought all my stores and provisions. Dekho tar modhe ki ki chilo, the stacks were 6 inches apart. Kemon kore lagano hoyechilo? 6 inchi kore gap rekhe prottekta. And I put the cables and rescued. So how the narrator actually made the tent? He rescued the things, some sticks and some the long sticks for the fortification, means to give the proper fencing around the house, and ultimately put a ladder. Means it was a very safety house where from he could save himself from any kind of wild creatures. How? Kibhabe shombhob? Now once he put the ladder, he goes to upwards. And after going to the up of the tent, upar uthar par jodi ki kore, he withdrew the ladder. The ladder take tule diten sidhi take. And ultimately he was totally disconnected from the area, from the outside world. So my dear students, is just to remember that how a man make a tent in the unknown wild, unknown place. How was the place where he actually wants to make the tent? After I had been on the island for 10 or 12 days, it occurred to me that I would lose the measure of time. This was because I had neither watch nor calendar. What happened? After a few days, after 12 days, the narrator was really forgot how to calculate or, you know, how to continue the days, because he has no calendar, you know, have neither any calendar nor any watch to prevent himself to count himself properly. In that circumstances, what he had done, so prevent these, I cut with my knife upon large post, and anek bodo gach ketini cut len, and date of my headings, I put my notch with my knife for every day. Every day he is actually giving a notch on it, ekta kore tini dag dite shuru korlen, and we remember him properly as how many days he passed there. So the question is there, that how the narrator actually protect himself from other places, and how did he remember the date one after another? That's all, my dear friend. I have completed the half portions of it. Just you remember next day and next portions. Thank you very much for watching this.